Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you and that you may live long in the land. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord. Bondservants, obey your earthly masters with fear and trembling, with a sincere heart as you would Christ, not by the way of eye service as people pleasers, but as bondservants of Christ, doing the will of God from the heart, rendering service with a good will as to the Lord and not to man, knowing whatever good anyone does, this he will receive back from the Lord, whether he is a bondservant or is free. Masters, do the same to them, and stop your threatening, knowing that he who is both their master and yours in heaven, and that there is no partiality with him.
All right, thanks, John.
Thank you. I think too that it's one thing for you to say that from the pulpit, but it's so much more impactful when those of us in the congregation are specifically going up to those parents and telling them the same thing, telling them, we're so glad that you're here. I cannot tell you how many times I've gone up to new parents and acknowledged, saying, I'm so glad that you're here, and acknowledged the child, and acknowledged that the child was here. Inevitably, the parent will begin to apologize for the child. And I tell the parent, I'm not sorry they're here. I love it. You did a great job with this or this or this. And you see that child just start to grow about 2 feet of, yeah, I was a big kid today, wasn't I? Okay. But you see the parent kind of grow a little bit too of, okay, this wasn't a massive disaster. Okay, we can do this again. But if they don't hear that from the people sitting in the pew next to them or in front of them, they're not going to believe it when you say it up front.
Yeah, that's good.
I Because they'd get stoned if they didn't obey.
Can we stop there? Any questions, comments, pushback on what we expect now?
Say you have a parent who smokes weed. How far does obedience and honoring go with that?
So like a kid, so in other words, probably they're asking obedience that is unreasonable. So it'd be kind of like what we talked about last week. If the kid's a Christian, or either way, I would say you honor God before you honor your parents.
But how in dishonoring do your parents, do you still maintain honor?
Man, you have to be more specific. It's just hard to generalize.
Like if a parent asks you to grab weed from their house so they can sell it to somebody who's outside waiting.
Thank you. Journey of not himself for the good of others, but it's worth it.
I think it's also important for parents to think about how in control of yourself are you in that moment. Oh. I've worked with parents before that, as we talked about, what can I do? Okay, this is where my kid is. This is what we're dealing with. I'm at the end of my rope. All I do is, and it's some type of spanking, or it's some type of physical punishment. And I've had to ask them before, wait a minute, so you're telling me that when you get to the end of your rope and you don't know what else to do and you've lost control, that's when you resort to a physical punishment. Does that sound like the best time to have any type of physical contact with another person? No. And so you see the light kind of turn on with that parent of, oh, I'm not in control of this moment, and I'm trying desperately to control this other one who doesn't want to be in control. No wonder there's chaos. So I think it's very important, especially with something like this, that you get another parent or you get another role model who can show you, teach you, mentor you, you need it, so that you are in control in that moment. I think there have been far too many cases where just sadness has come out because the parent was desperately trying to seek control when they didn't have control of themselves.
Some of the best discipline in my life, just thinking back, was it looked a lot like love and encouragement.
Yeah.
More absolutely than something that I got my spare share of spankings.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
4:14?
Yes, 4:14, reinforce.
So that we may no longer be children tossed to and fro by the waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness and deceitful scheme.
I I'm going to go to the next one.